In this day and age of smartphones, tablets, and other portable electronic devices that are expected to do hundreds of different tasks, sometimes it's nice to get back to basics with single-function devices. These are devices that just do one thing and do it well. They can be used at a moment's notice. They use batteries that last for months or even years, or in some cases don't use batteries at all. And they don't need to be booted up, unlocked, recharged, updated, or any other kind of nonsense like that. For example, a landline telephone, a clock, a calculator, or one of these things, a Weatheradio Cube. The very first Weatheradio Cube was introduced in 1970 at a price of $14.95. It was quickly replaced in 1971 with a slightly updated version that could tune additional frequencies. And then in 1976, another updated model was introduced, although it looked identical. And that model continued all the way until 1992. And in 1994, they introduced an updated version again, this time with the chrome and wood grain replaced with a black plastic case with a red strip across the top. That model lasted until 2000. Unfortunately, I don't know exactly when this model was introduced due to the lack of Radio Shack catalogs after 2002. But sometime in the 2000s, they came up with this, which is probably the final version of the Weatheradio Cube. And this nice black and red cube with a button on the top that lights up blue when you turn it on. This is the model 12-500. It sold for $19.99. As you can see from the date code, this one was made in July 2010. Runs on four AA batteries. And it has controls on the bottom for volume and tuning. And that's really about it. You just get your telescopic antenna, which you pull out for the best reception. It's about that long. This radio tunes into NOAA weather radio broadcasts, which operate on around 162 megahertz VHF using good old analog narrowband FM. Radio Shack advertised these weather radio cubes as being able to pick up broadcasts within a 25-mile radius, and that seems to be accurate with my experience with this one.
Seas around 3 feet. Tuesday, east winds around 5 knots, becoming south in the afternoon. Seas around 3 feet. Tuesday night, southwest winds around 10 knots. Seas around 3 feet.
Wednesday, currently giving the maritime broadcast.
Knots, becoming south 15 to 20 knots in the afternoon.
You get controls on bottom, like I said, for volume and tuning.
South winds 15 to 20 knots. Seas 4 to 7 feet. Winds and wind.
I think I can only pick up one station on this one.
Deserts for east central New Jersey. Howell Township.
Analog tuning.
You're listening to NOAA Weather Radio All Hazards on Station West XM60 from Southard, Howell Township, New Jersey on a frequency of 162.45 megahertz with a power of 300 watts. This programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Mount Holly, New Jersey. The station provides a 24-hour broadcast that includes regional warning information along with public, marine, hourly weather observations and climate data. If you have questions, please call us at 609-261-6600. Tests are run on Wednesdays between 11 a.m. and noon. Thank you for listening to NOAA Weather Radio. At 9 p.m. at Tom's River, light rain was falling.
Couldn't have planned that better if I tried. That was NOAA Weather Radio giving their own explanation of what the service provides. And all you need to tune in is one of these. Unfortunately, you can't buy one of these anymore because Radio Shack is out of business. But you can still buy other weather radio devices. And just about any scanner radio can tune in these broadcasts. The more advanced NOAA Weather Radio receivers also feature an alarm, which automatically sounds an alarm or can optionally turn on the receiver and start playing the broadcast whenever a severe weather alert is issued in your area, which is especially useful in areas which are prone to getting tornadoes and other severe weather hazards which require your immediate attention, regardless if your phone is charged or not. You can just keep a NOAA weather radio in your house. And anytime you want to hear the weather.
Following county, eastern Monmouth, New Jersey. Tomorrow, rip current risk, moderate. A moderate risk of rip currents implies that...
Or the marine broadcast, if you happen to be in a coastal area. Just turn on your weather radio and you can hear it.
Lightning threat, high. Implies that thunderstorms are likely or expected.